So what is inertial load? Inertial load goes back to Newton's first law of motion, or law of inertia. We're trying to overcome some sort of load that is in motion. This can be dictated by a couple of different ways. We have different variations of sizes of our weights or our inertial load, and it's dictated by the diameter. So starting from the middle, going out to the sides. We have our big red flywheel that we like to call it, but really it is also our heaviest flywheel. So as we get further in distance, it spreads out the weight of our inertial load, which creates either a greater force, or in terms of some of our smaller inertial loads, it has a higher velocity because the weight or the distribution of that load is a smaller diameter. When this relates to an exercise that we'll show you here in a second with our athlete Dejan, we can dictate the difference in force with some of our bigger inertial loads, or we can dictate the resistance of velocity with some of our smaller flywheels. Here, Dejan's gonna be doing a squat, and notice how fast or how much velocity comes out of this. Here he's slowly billeting in to very high or high velocity movements, very low inertial resistance. So here we have four flywheels. We have two reds, a dark blue, and then our yellow. Here we're gonna show the difference between what you just saw was more of a velocity-based movement to now something that's more force-based. Here we go. A lot slower of a movement, which will also then increase the force here based on how much inertial load that we have on, as well as the increase in diameter of the flywheels. So we have our big red, or our 0.1 inertial load, that is more for strength. Now, in terms of strength, sometimes that's very relative based on the athlete's abilities, whether they're a low biological age, young biological age, low training age, high training age, etc. So when I say strength, it is, think of it as relative. However, we can also add more than one flywheel to change that. So this is our strength flywheel for the majority of our lower body movements. This is our dark blue flywheel. This is our inertial resistance of 0.05. This is what we see as more of our power, or our hybrid, talking a little bit more about power development. This can also be used for more of those smaller, intricate upper body movements to provide still that heavier force side. Now again, it is a hybrid, so we have the best of both worlds, both force and velocity. Here we have our third category of flywheels. This is predominantly for velocity-based movement if we're talking about a lower body exercise, or more of our rehab flywheel for more intricate upper body movements like an internal, external rotation, a front lat row, etc. We have three options here that vary in inertial load depending on the specific movement that you're looking for, or the specific adaptation that you're looking for.